Hello? Fellow scientists? I can't see you. Ah, the electricity must be out, so there's nothing to power the lights. Well, I'll just use the flashlight on my phone to... No, I wasn't able to charge that without electricity. Maybe the screen of my computer could... Nope, that won't work either. Well, how are we supposed to do a lesson on electrical energy without any electricity? Okay, phew, crisis averted. Okay, how is this lesson supposed to start? Imagine a world without electricity. Now that's ironic, but it's true. Most of our daily lives rely on the use of electrical energy. But what is it exactly? And where does it come from? By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to explain the source of electrical energy, describe electricity, and identify some good conductors and insulators. You'll also be able to describe how static electricity is generated. Let's get into it. To understand electrical energy, we have to look back at those teeny tiny particles that are the building blocks of all matter, atoms. Atoms are made up of three even smaller particles, called subatomic particles: protons, neutrons, and electrons. Each of those particles carries a charge. Protons carry a positive charge, electrons carry a negative charge, and neutrons are neutral. They have no charge. The protons and the neutrons are clumped together in the center of the atom, while the electrons zoom around the outside. Pause the video here and label each subatomic particle in your guided notes. Electrical energy is the energy that's generated by the forces between these charged subatomic particles. Just like with magnets, the opposite charges in an atom attract, and the like charges repel. These forces of attraction and repulsion have a lot of potential to do work. Sometimes the forces can even push the electrons that are zooming around and move them between different atoms. That movement, or flow, of electrical energy is what we call electricity. So, electricity is the flow of electrical energy from the movement of electrons between atoms. When we harness that flow of energy, we're able to transport electricity to the outlets in our homes, powering our lights, running our TVs, even charging the device you're using to listen to me talk about electricity. The reason electricity is so commonly used to power whole houses, neighborhoods, and cities is because it can be efficiently transported between places. Because electricity is just a flow of electrons, if we give the electrons a medium to flow through, like a wire, we can reach far distances without too much effort. Much less effort than transporting, say, gasoline, which is heavy and needs to be burned to convert it into other forms of energy. In contrast, the materials needed to move electricity weigh nearly nothing, and it's easily transformed into other forms of energy, like light and heat. However, because electricity flows so easily, it can also be pretty dangerous. Electricity will continue to flow through any medium available to it, including the human body. This can cause harm like electric shocks, burns, and even death. That's why it's important to never play with electricity or put anything in an electrical outlet that isn't meant to be there. It's also why it's so important to understand how electrical energy moves through matter. This moving charge, what we call electric charge, flows through matter, but it doesn't travel through all materials in the same way. Materials that allow electric charge to flow easily are called conductors. Just as the conductor of an orchestra guides the musicians through a symphony, or a train conductor keeps the trains flowing to their destinations, conductive materials guide the flow of the electric charge and keep things moving. Metals like copper, silver, and steel make some of the best conductors. That's why the prongs of a plug, the insides of charging cords, and the power lines running along the poles outside are all made of metal. Metal isn't the only material that makes a good conductor, though. Water is an excellent conductor of electricity, which is why you should never swim when there's a thunderstorm, and why the shock of an electric eel is particularly powerful. The flow of electrons is able to move quickly through a conductor. Materials that prevent electric charge from flowing easily are called insulators. Think of insulating materials like the insulation of your house or the stuff inside the lining of a winter coat, keeping things inside. Some materials that make good insulators of electricity are glass, plastic, wood, and especially rubber. That's why the outside of all those cords we were talking about earlier are made of rubber, and why electricians might wear rubber gloves and shoes when dealing with high levels of electricity. So, conductors allow electric charge to flow easily, and insulators prevent electric charge from flowing. That's why... Whoa! It sounds like a big thunderstorm's on its way. That must have been what knocked out the power earlier. And that reminds me of another form of electrical energy I'm shocked I almost forgot. Static electricity. We know that the electricity that powers our homes comes from a flow of electric charge. That energy is kinetic. The charges are in motion, moving between atoms. However, sometimes that electric charge doesn't move from atom to atom. Instead, it stays in one place, building up more and more potential energy. Let's take another look at an atom. Remember how the protons in the center of an atom have a positive charge, and the electrons on the outside have a negative charge? Usually, atoms have the same number of negative electrons and positive protons, so their charges balance out, making most matter neutral. But sometimes, when objects come into contact with each other, like a balloon touching your hair, some of the electrons can transfer between objects. In this case, some of the electrons from your hair are transferred to the balloon. As the balloon accumulates more and more electrons, its balance between positive and negative charges is thrown off. This charge imbalance is what we call static electricity. The balloon is now more negatively charged, and your hair is more positively charged. And as we all know, opposites attract. We also know that like charges repel, which is why it looks like your hairs are trying to get away from each other when they're all staticky. All the positive charges are repelling. The problem is, energy likes to be in balance. If an object continues to accumulate more and more negatively charged electrons, building up a lot of potential energy, then the forces of repulsion between the electrons are going to get so great that eventually they'll have to jump somewhere else, often resulting in a shock. This is just what happens with lightning. Particles coming into contact in the clouds exchange electrons, building up static electricity. The potential energy continues to build until it is so great the electrons jump to the more positively charged ground, resulting in a huge explosion of energy in the form of light, heat, and sound. Static electricity pops up in a lot more places than just balloons and lightning bolts. What experiences have you had with static electricity? Pause the video here and jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. On that shocking note, let's review everything we've learned about electrical energy today. Electricity is the form of energy generated by the forces between charged subatomic particles, and electricity is the kinetic flow of electrical energy. Conductors, such as metals, allow electric charges to flow easily through them, and insulators, such as rubber, prevent electrical charges from flowing. When electric charges don't flow, and instead build up in one place, it results in the potential energy of static electricity. To learn more about electrical energy, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson. Oh, sorry. Thanks to the electricity coming back on, my phone was finally able to charge. So I was looking up some really cool stuff about how our brains use electricity to send signals. Well then, at least the electricity in my brain is still working. Until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time.
Hey, hey. Whoa.